Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer. It's Monday, May 17. Let's go through the pages. For the breviary, we're in volume 2. Our hymn is 1420. Our first antiphon, 1383. Our reading, 968. The Benedictus at 1051. For the Christian prayer book, it's hymn number 4. Our first antiphon is 867, reading 583, the Benedictus 691. Let's have a moment of silence and we can begin our prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken.
My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God. Alleluia. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord God of hosts.
My soul is longing and yearning, is yearning for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my soul ring out their joy to God, the living God.
The sparrow herself finds a home, and the swallow a nest for her brood. She lays her young by your altars, Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
They are happy who dwell in your house, forever singing your praise. They are happy though strength is in you, in whose hearts are the roads to Zion.
As they go through the bitter valley, they make it a place of springs. The autumn rain covers it with blessings. They walk with ever-growing strength. They will see the God of gods in Zion.
O Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob. Turn your eyes, O God our shield. Look on the face of your anointed.
One day within your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. The threshold of the house of God I prefer to the dwellings of the wicked.
For the Lord God is a rampart, a shield. He will give us his favor and glory. The Lord will not refuse any good to those who walk without blame.
Lord God of hosts, happy the man who trusts in you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God. Alleluia.
The house of the Lord has been raised on high, and all the nations will go up to it. Alleluia. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest mountain and raised above the hills.
All nations shall return, stream towards it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us climb the Lord's mountain, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may instruct us in his ways, and we may walk in his paths."
For from Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem.
He shall judge between the nations, and impose terms on many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. One nation shall not raise the sword against another, nor shall they train for war again.
O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The house of the Lord has been raised on high, and all the nations will go up to it. Alleluia.
Proclaim this among the nations. The Lord is King. Alleluia. Oh, sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Oh, sing to the Lord. Bless his name.
Proclaim his help day by day. Tell among the nations his glory and his wonders among all the peoples.
The Lord is great and worthy of praise, to be feared above all gods. The gods of the heathens are not.
It was the Lord who made the heavens. His are majesty and state and power and splendor in his holy place.
Give the Lord, you families of peoples, give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name.
Bring an offering and enter his courts. Worship the Lord in his temple. O earth, tremble before him.
Proclaim to the nations, God is King. The world he made firm in its place. He will judge the peoples in fairness.
Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let the sea and all within it thunder praise. Let the land and all it bears rejoice. All the trees of the wood shout for joy.
At the presence of the Lord, for he comes. He comes to rule the earth. With justice he will rule the world. He will judge the peoples with his truth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Proclaim this among the nations. The Lord is King. Alleluia.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. For if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Faith in the heart leads to justification, confession on the lips to salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The word is near you. Everyone knows about salvation. If a person doesn't receive salvation, it's not because it's unavailable. All we need is the will to receive the word, because it is within our reach. The gospel of salvation is not something outside us. It's that we have to earn. It's rather, it's inside a person. working from inside out. When Jesus is in us, good is manifested naturally. However, Satan is constantly bombarding our minds that God requires us to prove ourselves to him before he can bless us. Paul's main thrust on the word of salvation is not obtained by working for it from outside yourself. God blesses us from baptism because Jesus justifies our sins. When he died and raised from the dead, all we need to do is believe and receive it.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
He hung upon the cross for us.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
The world will persecute you, but have courage. I have overcome the world. Alleluia. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The world will persecute you, but have courage. I have overcome the world. Alleluia. Christ promised to send the Holy Spirit from the Father in his name to be our helper and guide. Let us bless him and ask him, Lord Jesus, give us your Spirit.
Lord Jesus, we thank you and through you the Father also in the unity of the Holy Spirit.
May everything we say and do today be in your name.
Give us the Holy Spirit to dwell within us,
that we may be living members in your body.
Grant that we may never condemn or despise others,
for we shall all one day face you as our own judge.
Fill us with the fullness of joy and peace in believing,
that we may be rich in hope and in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Let's have a moment of silence to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of everyone praying with us this morning. We ask, Lord Jesus, that you hear and answer our prayers as we say,
Lord Jesus, give us your Spirit. We now pray the prayer your Son Jesus has taught us himself. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, send the power of your Holy Spirit upon us, that we may remain faithful and do your will in our daily lives. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord bless us, protect us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time.
Same place.
Same channel.
Have a great day.